I don't do that. look at something and I figure it out. Okay, so we're gonna go with a half a cup of granulated white sugar. Half a cup of packed brown sugar. Okay. Let's mix. Now remember, we're not going to be like all rough and tumble about it, right? We're going to fold our ingredients in. So the because the bananas are nice and, well, they're overripe, but they're ripe, nice and ripe, and the brown sugar is going to add a really nice nutty kind of caramelization to it. Now some things that you can also consider adding in here that are strictly optional are like walnuts or really any kind of nut that you like, but not really nut. I mean, I've got peanut in the house, but yeah. Your choice, I'm going to be adding chocolate because that's what the little people here like, so that's what we're going to add. So. I will actually kind of properly measure out my flour to some degree. So I'm going to start with 1.5 cups of all-purpose flour. Have to hear children screaming, but how many times do you see me make a mess? That's how many times you see flowers, because that's what my grandfather used to tell me. Alright, let's fix this lighting. Alright, tripod is coming, I promise. The lighting seems to be better when my device here is raised, so I'm just going to raise things for you, as we go. Okay, so we're lightly going to fold in our flour, and we're starting with 1.5 cups of flour because I want to put in some oats, okay? So we're just going to fold this in. Don't be rushing with it. Don't get a whisk. Just nice folding in. So how are you guys doing with COVID-19? I live in Ontario, Canada. Don't think that's disclosing too much about that. But we're starting to go in what the Premier, Mr. Doug Ford, calls Stage 1. I believe we start that on the 19th of the month, where certain things kind of reopen. So I'm very excited because my Poochie, my little old Jack Russell, is going for a haircut next week. He's going to be so handsome. He's a Jack and he looks like a Westie because he's so overgrown. Dropping stuff. Didn't make a mess. I did not make a mess. I'm just dropping stuff. Okay, and we're gonna add in a cup of oats. Now I am using the quick oats because I like that they're small. I like the texture and they kind of Oh, if you guys could see my mess right now. And yes, I do clean it. Like, I don't make other people do it. They don't offer. Also, I'd be like, oh, that's so sweet of you. Anyways. My Jack Russell looks like a Westie. I made a mess. Okay, so we don't want our dough, our batter here, to be rock solid, right? We don't want it to be hard. We want it to have some sort of moisture to it because it's going to be a very lovely cake like that. So we're going to keep the moisture here the way it is. I've got here hands. Carpal tunnel, guys. Surgery on it. See the moistness of the dough? The batter? Okay. This is the consistency. Better lighting that we are looking for. So to this, I am going to add about a cup of semi-sweet chocolate chips. Now I like semi-sweet chocolate chips because they're not quite dark, they're not quite milk chocolate. I actually prefer the chipettes too because I like them nice and tiny. But there's a lot of sweetness, right? You've got the sweetness from the bananas, from the sugars. Okay, so I'm gonna add in about a cup. Sorry guys, this is totally... That's how I measure. It's really hard when I do these videos for you guys because a lot of people are like, oh my god, I want this recipe, I want that recipe, please teach me how to do it, please, please, please. I don't have a recipe. It was so hard when I wrote my cookbook. It was so hard. Like, I had to get people to edit my cookbook and see if it made sense to them and try recipes to make sure, like, okay, yeah, and all the feedback was just like, bomb. Oh my gosh. But I don't sit here looking at Pinterest. I don't go online and see what other people are doing. I have an idea. I think about it. I fail sometimes. But then when I figured it out, I come here and I do it for you, lovely people. Okay, so you are going to grease your cake pan or whatever vessel you are using. Again, I'm using a Bundt cake pan. You can use whatever cooking spray you want. It is legit so much cheaper to get these things from Costco. Legit so much cheaper. Just give it a nice coating. And this is going to go and hang out in that oven for a good 50 to 65 minutes at 375, depending on the performance of your oven. Okay, so I'm gonna hope that I don't drop the bowl. My hands are really terrible, so it is a distinct possibility that this will happen. Okay. We're gonna pause it. Okay guys, my timer's gone off. It's been about 45 minutes. Let's check her out. Now, you're gonna check with a toothpick, right? You're gonna insert a toothpick in to see if she's ready. I just want to point out that my edges look lovely and caramelized. So I'm thinking this is a good indication that she's probably ready. I don't have a toothpick. I also don't have spaghetti in here, nor would I want to put in raw spaghetti. So I'm just going to use a steak knife. I'm going to insert it all the way to the bottom and pull out. The only thing that's there is chocolate. We're going to try it again. Chocolate. Okay. So she's ready. She's good. At this point, I've shut the oven off. I'm going to, well, this is my anniversary. I got to go to... on a drive to go and get something for dinner. And it's far, so I'm gonna let this hang out. What I would suggest doing is letting it rest in the pan until it is lukewarm to the touch. When that happens, turn it over, let it rest on a wired rack. If you don't have a wired rack, guys, there's things that you can do. If you have an insert from your convection oven, use that, pull it out, use that. You know, if I'm doing a mass amount of baking because it's Christmas time and I'm trying to get everything ready, my Gotham Steel hair part here. Okay. So this is my Gotham Steel pan. Legit. I mean, you may see some grooves and indentations on your cookies and whatnot, but it's fine. It's the bottom. Nobody's really going to see that. All they're going to care about is how does it taste. Does it taste bomb diggity? Blessed. You're good. So, I mean, there's lots of ways to get around without having to spend extra money on things that you're probably hardly ever going to use. Now, I do a considerable amount of baking when it comes to bread and other things. Probably not a good thing because it's like a sugar bypass. However, such is life. And, you know, this is an easy recipe. These are things that I make when I've got my meetings in the home, pre-COVID-19, when I've got meetings in the home, and I've got to put something out. So, super easy, right? Like, what did it take us to get ready? 5 minutes? Most likely you have sugar in the house, you've got salt, you've got baking soda, at least in the fridge, baking powder, you've got some sort of vanilla extract, you likely have eggs, flour, the oats. Here's a simple thing if you want to get around the oats, because you don't want to buy a big bag of oats. If you have oatmeal packets in your house, just use some oatmeal packets. I've also done this recipe with using the apple brown sugar oatmeal packets. So what I'll do is I will eliminate all of the brown sugar, the packed brown sugar that I've put in. I won't even put that in. I'll just use the sugar contents that's already in the oatmeal packet itself. We're moms, you know. Sometimes we don't always have the best things around, and you have to improvise. In terms of a budget thing, I mean, bananas went bad. I got the bag of bananas itself for like $1.50 at Costco. I used 5 out of it. So what is that, like 75 cents between the butter, maybe 75 cents for $1.50. The sugars, maybe 50 cents, so we're at $2. The eggs, maybe 50 cents because I buy 30 pack from Costco, so $2.50. The chocolate chips, all right, that's where it might get a little expensive. $2.50, the bag was $2, so $1, so $3.50. So $3.50 to $4 tops. And it's going to be much better than anything else you can get at the grocery store. I'll come back later when I've gotten all my food and whatnot, and we'll give it a test for you. We'll cut it open so you can see what it looks like. It smells so yummy, guys. I'm excited. Okay, guys, I'm back from my journey. Whoop. That came out real nice. It's because I totally just let it sit in there. Wow. Isn't she pretty? All right. Whoop. Let's cut into it real quick just to try it. You have the tiniest smidge because it's right before dinner. But just so you guys can get a look. Probably don't recommend cutting it on that, but it looks lovely. It's still nice and warm. It's cooked through. I got no words. I mean, it's delicious. The oats are really nice. The texture is really nice. The crispiness, the caramelization from the brown sugar. That's a little bit of a nuttiness. It's delicious. There you go. That's all I got for you. I hope you enjoy. Like, share, subscribe. Enjoy, guys. We'll see you later.